It's day two of the swimming competition of the Chengdu 2021 FISU World University Games as we welcome you to the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Aquatic Center for the medals session. The American coach, David Armbruster, is credited with adding the dolphin kick to the butterfly stroke. Now an athlete that shares his name, Luca Armbruster, goes for gold in lane four. Chen of China will go in lane six. He's certainly an outside bet of a medal. Majerski will go in lane one. He is quick in the free. He is quick in the fly, very much a sprinter. But Adilbek Muhsin, don't discount the Kazakh swimmer going in lane eight. And Thomas Verhoeven going for Netherlands from lane five. 23 too low. Lorenzo Gargani, one to watch as well. Personal bests in the heats and in the semi-finals. When you're posting those kind of times and you're feeling good, it could very well be your race. Butterfly is certainly a very difficult stroke to master. Technically, you have to be so correct. Verhoeven of Netherlands going in five. Armbruster, the German national record holder, goes in four. He must be the favorite for this, the quickest of the qualifiers and the top seed in this event. Majerski, Jun, Gargani, Armbruster, Verhoeven, Chen, the Silva Santos and Muhsin. Getting away quickly in this men's 50-meter butterfly, the first final of the medal session on day two of competition. It was Chun of Korea who got away very nicely in lane two. His underwater looked good as well through the 25-meter mark, but Chun looks to be leading only just the 19-year-old. He's going nicely, but he's been passed now by Armbruster, who's got into his stroke. Armbruster, is he going to be able to challenge all the way to the wall? Gargani's coming back at him, but who's going to touch it first? It's Armbruster just ahead of Gargani, and Majerski touches with a very fast finish. Tie for second, so two silver medals in this race and a gold, no bronze to come. But Luca Armbruster, what a race. From the 25 meter mark onwards, it was all Armbruster. 23-22, not his quickest time, but he'll take it. Gargani alongside him, a dead heat for the silver medal. And Majerski from lane one goes 23-39 and picks up a silver medal. Armbruster on the stroke, he timed it perfectly. Chen of China just fading in the closing stages as he touched fourth and outside the medals, but it's Gargani and Majerski who tie for the silver. A dead heat for silver. Luca Armbruster of Germany is your champion in the men's 50 fly. Confirming the medalists in the men's 50-meter butterfly, Germany's Luca Armbruster is the champion. A dead heat for second. The silver medal shared by Poland's Majerski and Gargani of Italy. Two Americans, two Italians, Japan, Romania, Poland and Brazil also represented in this men's 100-meter backstroke final. Lamberti was the quickest to the 50 in the field with a 25.95 in the semi-final. Stokowski paced himself nicely in both the heats and the semis, going out in a 26 low. Stefani looks to be a swimmer, though, on form, breaking that 54-second barrier for the first time here as he won the first semi-final in 53.87. He swims in lane four. That's Lamberti, who goes in three. Michele Lamberti, I should say, brother of Matteo, who are both swimming here. The only stroke in which swimmers start in the pool is the backstroke. This is the men's 100-meter backstroke. Matsuyama, Popescu, Lamberti, Stefani, Stokowski, Jones, DeRojo and Janton. Good reaction time from Stokowski, so too from Matsuyama going in lane one. Very much the Japanese swimmers, so good off the reaction times and really explode off the start. Stokowski is getting into his stroke, but he's just a little behind Stefani at the moment. Lamberti is not looking too far off Stefani, who looks to be leading coming up toward the 50-meter mark. Jansen is going well, so too is Jones of the United States. They go in 1 and 3. Jansen touches ahead of De Rojo of Brazil. Popescu of Romania, in fact, in lane 2, is touched third quickest. As Stefani and Lamberti just tucked off a little going into the turn. This is the critical part of this race, the critical phase, the final 25 meters. Suddenly Stefani has burst to life and he is pushing the pace now. The Italian, he's being challenged on his inside by Lamberti. The Italian's going head to head. Can they make it an Italian 1-2? It is Stefani ahead of Lamberti with Popescu of Romania touching third quickest. Italy, further success in the pool. And both Matteo and Michele Lamberti are now medalists at the Chengdu 2021 FISU World University Games. Some brotherly love and some further success for Italy. An Italian 1-2. Simone Stefani controlled this race after an elegant start and a delightful underwater. Bided his time. Not quite on the stroke, rocked his body, went in for the glide, touched the wall first, and 700ths of a second ahead of compatriot Lamberti. Simone Stefani is the champion, with Popescu of Romania claiming Romania's first medal in the pool here at Chengdu 2021. Confirming the medalists in the men's 100-meter backstroke, Denis Lorien Popescu of Romania, bronze. Silver to Michele Lamberti, and compatriot Simone Stefani with the gold medal in 53.95. This is the final of the women's 50 fly. Beckman, Hiroshita, Scotto, Chang, Gallagher, La Quintana, Pira and Zandringer of Netherlands. Zhang Yufei, the crowd very much behind the multiple Olympic, multiple world champion. Beckman, 25.50 at her best. While she swam a 26.60 in the semi-finals, at her best, she is capable of not only challenging for a medal, but even winning this race. Zhang and Gallagher have already tied in the semi-finals of the 100 freestyle in this session. Now they go in the final. Beckman, Hiroshita, Scotto, Zhang, Gallagher, La Quintana, Pira and Zandringer. And we're off in the final of the women's 50-meter butterfly. Great underwater from Zhang Yufei. Alongside her is Erin Gallagher going in 5. Zhang already pulling out a remarkable lead. Coming up toward the 25-meter mark, she's asserting her dominance now. She might even be looking to go around the 25-second mark in this final. Can she go below 25 seconds? She's edging closer now. Erin Gallagher is challenging, coming back at her in lane 5. Will settle for a medal, but it is Zhang Yufei who touches in 25.20 and claims gold in front of her home crowd. It's a very fine result for South Africa's Erin Gallagher, who sets a new South African record, just off the African record as well, with her 25.66. And Scotto of Italy medals with a 26.01. Great reaction time from Zhang Yufei. By the 25-meter mark, after an exceptional streamline underwater, she came up a little way in front, got into her stroke, half a body length in front by 25 meters and extended it. Gallagher tried to come back at her in the closing stages. 25.66, good enough for silver. Zhang, gold in FISU record time, 25.20. Bronze goes to Italy's Viola Scotta Di Carlo. New South African record for Erin Gallagher, who takes silver and Africa's first medal in the pool in Chengdu. But gold belongs to the peerless home heroine, Zhang Yufei, who won the women's 50-meter fly in FISU record time, 25.20. Viberti, Pinzuto, Kawasowski, Chin, Sidlauskas, Fukusawa, Song and Hanagaruma. Japan have two swimmers, Italy have two swimmers, China have two swimmers. Poland and Lithuania also represented in this men's 100-meter breaststroke final, an event that tests speed off the blocks, solid underwaters, proper technique and genuine leg power. Only Hanagaruma, Sidlauskas and Chin have gone sub 60 seconds. Can they prove it in the pool? Sidlauskas of Lithuania having a good competition, but this man is quite literally on top of the world champion, Chin. Italy have two swimmers, Viberti and Pinzuto, going in one and two. So Viberti, Pinzuto, Kawusowski, Chin, Sidlauskas, Fukasawa, Song and Hanuguruma. This is the men's 100-meter breaststroke final, an event that has certainly tested the competitors off the starters' blocks as well. Fukasawa with a very fine start, so to Chin Haiyang of People's Republic of China going in lane four. And the world champion is edging in front through 25 meters. Alongside him, Andreas Sidlauskas looking to pace himself over the 100-meter breaststroke. He is not too far off the pace that is being set by Chin, going nicely in lanes one and two as well are the two Italians. It is Chin who touches ahead of Sidlauskas with Pinzuto of Italy in lane two, around half a second off the pace at the 50-meter mark, but a great turn from a man who's got a solid underwater, has exceptional technique and has incredible leg power. Chin Haiyang, the world champion who smashed the Infinity's FISU record by over a second in the semi-finals. He looks to be a little off that time in this final, but a good second half potentially here is going to see him cruise to the title. Chin Haiyang alongside him, though, are the other medalists, Sidlauskas and Kawasowski. It looks like Kawasowski gets second just ahead of Sidlauskas, but it is Chin Haiyang of People's Republic of China, of Tongji University, who is the champion here at the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Aquatic Center. Good reaction time, solid opening 50, turned in 27.58 and comes home in 58.92. Not his best, but what a back end from Kołsowski of Poland. 59.86, the first time he's gone sub 60 seconds, and 59.89 for Sidlauskas of Lithuania as he finishes third. In the men's 100-meter breaststroke, bronze to Andreas Sidlauskas of Lithuania. Poland's Jan Kołsowski secured the silver, but the Chengdu 2021 champion is the reigning world champion, Chin Haiyang of China. So, Gao, Toma, Pierce, Sabo, Feltotti, Rodriguez, Liu, Saltitan, and Pasquino. While Pierce swam a personal best in the semi-finals, most swimmers paced themselves. They were well off their top time, so expect far quicker times than the 2:11.21 that led the field in the semis. Pierce went out in 1:05.03 in the semi-finals, came home in a 33.15 over the final 50 metres. Now there are a range of tactics that will be employed by each of the swimmers. They will plunge into the pool. At her best, Liu Yashin of China, who goes in six, is a 2:07 swimmer. Maybe a FISU record on the cards. Gao, Toma, Pierce, Sabo, Feltotti, Rodriguez, Liu, Salchitan, and Pasquino. As we get underway in the women's 200-meter backstroke final, it's a really good underwater from Rodriguez. Going in five. It's a really quick start as well for Toma of Italy going in two, and a really decent start for Gao Xing of China going in lane one. Going out in the wide lanes, though, are Pasquino of Italy in eight and Salchitan of Moldova going in seven. And they look like they're coming up to the wall in a position to touch first. A great reaction time from Pasquino, who started through the opening 50. It is Pasquino who leads ahead of Salchitan of Moldova. Rodriguez of Portugal from lane five, 0.36 down on the leader. But this is a race in which pacing again is so important. Finding that rhythm so early on is critical in determining the outcome of a race. You don't want to go out too fast. You also don't want to go out too slowly and leave yourself with too much to do. Liu Yashin looks like she's coming into her own at the moment. The Shanghai Chiatong University student, the reigning Asian Games champion, the fastest in the field, turns first ahead of Rodriguez. Sabo Feltotti got herself nicely back into contention with that second 50 meter. But Liu Yashin, quickest in the field over the second 50. Camila Rodriguez, second quickest over that second 50. She touches in 1:03.74 at the wall. A good battle prospectively on the cards for medals in this final. But Liu Yashin looks to be taking this race by the scruff of the neck. Didn't go out too hard. Looks like she is pushing in the middle 50 and giving herself a tremendous advantage. How about that for a turn? And underwater from Liu ahead of Sabor Feltoti. Rodriguez of Portugal is still very much in the mix. But it is Liu Yashin, the 24-year-old, the home favourite, who is leading by well over a body length at the moment in lane six. She's pushing the pace as well. She was quickest at the 100 mark, quickest at the 150 mark. She's just off the FISU record at the moment, but she looks like she's going to swim at 208. She comes to the wall now, 208.18. China champions again, second for Rodriguez as she edges out Sabor Feltoti. Not much separating them. Pierce of South Africa touches outside the medals. So too missing out on a medal is Salchitan of Moldova and Toma of Italy. But a champion in the pool, Liu Yashin, did not go out too hard. 31.04, composed herself in the opening 50. Paschino, the Italian in eight, went out hardest, the 30.52. But at the 100-meter mark, she started to make her move, did Liu Yashin, and her back 100 was superb. An accomplished stroke, an accomplished swim, great intensity over the back 100, and she is champion in the women's 200-meter backstroke. Liu Yashin of China, ahead of Rodriguez of Portugal and Hungary's Sabor Feltoti, the bronze medalist. Hungary's Esther Sabor Feltoti takes bronze, silver to Camila Rodriguez of Portugal, and gold to Liu Yashin of People's Republic of China in the women's 200-meter backstroke. But this mixed 4x100 medley relay final should be exceptional. People's Republic of China are heavily favoured for the gold. They go alongside Japan in five. It's teams of four swimmers, two men, two women, racing against one another, with each member swimming one 100-meter leg in a different stroke. So the race will start in the water with a backstroke leg, then breast, then fly, and then they finish with free. And there are a range of strategies that you can employ, and you'll see different countries employing those varying tactics. As long as you have two male and two female swimmers, it doesn't matter in what order they swim. You ultimately want to get your fastest swimmers in their best strokes in the pool. Brazil, Poland, USA, China, Japan, Korea, Italy, Hong Kong, China. The first time the mixed 4x100 medley relay is being swum as a final at the FISU World University Games. Who will be crowned inaugural champions? This race that starts in the water with a backstroke leg, the breast, then the fly, and then the free to finish. Two lengths of this Olympic-sized pool for each of the competitors in the quartet for the respective countries. It looks like Japan leading up towards the wall, and in lane seven, Italy are looking really quick. They are just ahead of Poland as well. Japan touched third, so Italy in the pool are leading, courtesy of Simone Stefani, who leads out for Italy, already a champion in the pool at these games. Going very nicely as well is Stokowski for Poland in lane two, but it is Italy who are taking it to their opponents. Now, bear in mind, there are female swimmers in the pool and male swimmers in the pool at the same time, and that's what makes it so exciting. You might have a team that looks like it's got plenty of work to do to catch up, suddenly be able to do that with finishing with male-male swimmers. Italy, Poland and China are very much in the mix as we come into the breaststroke leg now, the second leg. China are the team to beat. They clocked the fastest time in the heat and they didn't use any of their fastest swimmers in each of their stroke. They've got the fly world champion Zhang Yufei to come. They've got the breaststroke world champion Qin Haiyang in the pool at the moment. The 24-year-old is making sure China are still very much in the mix. USA are coming back into it, courtesy of Kevin Hausman, the 22-year-old. That's a great swim from Kevin Hausman, the breaststroker, and still going strong in lane seven are Italy, courtesy of Alessandro Pinzuto. But they will finish with female-female, with Giulia Di Vincenzo next to come, and then Viola Scotta Di Carlo to finish for the Italians. It looks like they'll touch second, because Qin Haiyang is going to bring China home at the wall, just 2.24 of a second ahead of Italy. USA nearly a second and a half back, but they're in the mix for the bronze medal. So too are Japan. They've got a female swimmer in the pool at the moment. Hiroshita in the pool for Japan. Leading the way, though, is the fly world champion over 100 meters, Zhang Yufei, in her third event of the night. Already a finalist in the 100 free, a champion in the 50 fly. She swims the 100 fly leg in this race, and she is absolutely commanding the pool at the moment, nearly 2 seconds ahead of Italy now. Japan are ahead of USA in third. It's looking good for Japan. They've still got one swimmer to go in the pool with Matsumoto to swim the freestyle leg. Amy Tang will swim the freestyle leg for USA. They are battling for a bronze medal at the moment. But China are leading the way, and China are really convincing at the moment. Going in lane two, though, Poland are back in the mix. 144 off the pace, Italy 270 off the pace. China, Poland and Italy in the medal mix with 100 meters to go. It is another one of world champion medalist Li Bingzhe. While she's known more for her distance swimming, she is very fast over 100 meter freestyle. China are not going to be caught. I don't suspect that Poland are going to be touched, as Kornelia Witkiewicz is swimming really well, going in lane two and touches second, one, effectively 1.5 seconds off the pace. Italy holding on courtesy of Jeloscotta Di Carlo, already a medalist at these games. In this session, touching third quickest, but coming back in lane five are Japan, courtesy of Matsumoto, and are looking to medal. It's going to be an incredible battle. The record is going to be absolutely smashed here, the FISU record. China, with their A-team, are going to cruise to victory in record time. It is exceptional. 3:44.02. The silver goes to Poland, and Italy hold on for bronze. But People's Republic of China, what a session they have had. Li Bingzhe brings home a quartet that started off with Wang Gukailai, Qin Haiyang in the breaststroke, Zhang Yufei in the fly. Just an exceptional race. And a build-up to what proved to be an incredible crescendo for the home fans who made their way to the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Aquatic Center. China dominated. Fly world champ Zhang Yufei, who swam China to gold at the World Aquatics Championships in Fukuoka last week. Breaststroke world champ Qin Haiyang, a triple world gold medalist in the breaststroke events at the recent World Championships. Li Bingzhe, take nothing away from her achievement in the pool as well. Japan just outside the medals as Italy touched second. But an incredible 3:44 for People's Republic of China. They are champions in FISU record time, 3:44.02. It was a dominant display from China, the host nation, ahead of Poland, ahead of Italy. And Poland and Italy are racking up the medals at these games. Italy secure the bronze, Poland take silver, and the quartet of Wang, Qin, Zhang and Li claim the mixed 4x100 medley relay gold in FISU record time, 3:44.02.